this coil is called transcranial magnetic stimulation. So I click it and that induces a twitch in my hand, which, there we go, right, there we go. So if Sarah stimulates this side of my head, it'll make this hand move, right? And if she did this side, it'll make this side move. See that? Mm-hmm. So my hand basically twitches. So you can see actually the twitch is happening around this area of my hand. It's a little finger. If you move the coil, you get a different part of the hand, right?
Wow.
And if you're very good at this, you can actually basically move across the fingers, because inside your brain, you have representations of your whole body.
Correct.
A large portion of the brain is taken up by representations of your hand.
Is this the basic concept behind deep brain stimulation?
In the case of deep brain stimulation, it's very deep in the brain, so by giving the name, so it's, which gives it away, right? You're right in the sense that the brain is an electric organ, and we can influence it by stimulating it with electricity, either by inducing it with magnetism or by direct electrical stimulation. I think neuroscience is such a fascinating thing, because we just don't know anything about the brain. The more we understand, anything more we understand, the more, you know, it'll allow us to kind of use those things in the future. Because, you know, what we want to do is learn how the brain works and then apply those principles to kind of to people with conditions like Parkinson's and other brain disorders. I mean, you know, the more we know about the brain itself, the more we will be able to combat disorders of the brain.
I've never been to a research facility before. This is a great experience for me to actually see what it is that a research scientist does, how they do it. And, you know, there's the emotional part of it and the connection. We've seen, okay, somebody else actually does, in fact, care about the issues that I'm going through. And it really, really debunked the thought of my preconceived notions about what research is and isn't. You know, it's a lot less scary.
No, we try our best.
Well, it can be a lot less scary.
Yeah.